you, folks. Abortion is a controversial issue, and at the center of the controversy is the question of whether the unborn are human beings. If they are, then abortion kills a human being. Many people think that this is somehow a religious issue and involves religious questions like when the soul arrives. Some people deliberately try to frame the issue this way in order to shut down rational discussion of the subject. So let's set the question of religion aside entirely. Instead, let's look at something we should all be able to agree on: science. What does science say about whether the unborn are human beings? It's a reasonable question. After all, if somebody is an adult, we don't say it's a religious issue whether he's a human being. Nobody says, "I don't know if this 35-year-old man has a soul. That's a religious issue, so I can go ahead and kill him." It's a human universal, a principle honored in all human cultures, that you cannot kill other human beings at will. There may be special circumstances like war or self-defense or the death penalty for crimes, but apart from those circumstances, you cannot kill another human being. It is always and everywhere wrong to deliberately kill an innocent, non-aggressive human being. So, keeping religion out of it, what does somebody need in order to qualify as a human being scientifically? Well, scientifically speaking, a human being is a member of the human species. What separates our species from other species? There are obviously many characteristics that we possess that are different in degree or kind from other species. These manifest at different times in our lives under normal development. They aren't all there from the beginning. But underlying all of them is our genetic code. That's really the thing that, on a scientific level, distinguishes us from other species. It's what drives and shapes our development and our abilities, whether mental or physical. Members of the human species have a human genetic code, while members of other species have their own genetic codes. Thus, the genetic code of a rabbit, or for that matter, a carrot, is different than the genetic code of a human being. It's important to note, though, that just because something has a particular genetic code doesn't make it a member of a species. For example, if you took a skin sample from me, you'd get cells that have a human genetic code, but one of those cells, or even a chunk of my flesh, wouldn't be a member of the human species. The reason is that they are merely parts of a larger organism, namely me. I'm an organism, and I'm a member of the human species. An individual cell, or even a part of my body, is not. From what we've seen, we can thus say that a member of the human species, a human being, is a living human organism. If it meets those three conditions, if it's living, if it has a human genetic code, and if it's a complete organism rather than a part of another one, then from a scientific perspective, it is a human being. So, what about the unborn? It's obvious that the unborn are living. From the time of conception, they have cellular processes taking place, they have metabolism, they're spending energy, growing and developing. The fact that they are alive is clear because dead embryos don't grow. They also have a human genetic code. They've had one since the sperm and egg came together and the two halves of their genetic material joined. And it's clearly a human genetic code, not that of a rabbit or a carrot or anything else. The question, then, is whether they are organisms in their own right or part of another organism. Here again, the answer is clear. They are their own organisms. They're not part of the mother's body. The cells of her body have their own genetic code, distinct from that of the child. From the moment of conception, the unborn are individual organisms, with their own inner processes driving their growth and development. So, scientifically speaking, unborn children are living human organisms. They are members of the human species. They are human beings. That awareness has been growing already. People are more pro-life now than they were 40 years ago when abortion was first legalized in America. Even those who advocate abortion are more willing to acknowledge now that the unborn are human beings than they were back then. The reality is progressively harder to deny as science learns more about our development in the womb and as people become more scientifically educated about it. With time and education, a culture of life is growing. If you'd like to help promote the culture of life, I'd suggest taking even small steps. Like this video, or better yet, share it with others. Incidentally, if you like the information I've presented here, I'd invite you to check out my Secret Information Club. That's a free service I offer by email, and it is religion-related. I try to send out fascinating information related to the Catholic faith, and in fact, the very first thing I send out is a mailing on what Pope Benedict has to say about the Book of Revelation. He has some very interesting things to say, so I hope you'll check it out. You can do that and sign up by going to www.secretinfoclub.com. Thank you.